Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Mark Levine, and I am proud to be the Deputy Director of your New York State Association of Counties. On behalf of our President, Jack Maron, and our Executive Director, Stephen Aquario, I want to thank you for joining us this afternoon. I am very excited for this afternoon's virtual fall seminar workshop on reopening to the public safely. This is week two of our virtual 2020 fall seminar, our first ever virtual fall seminar. So far, we have had six workshops and trained more than 600 county officials from 55 counties across New York State. Our fall seminar is taking place from September 15th through October 1st and includes 20 workshops and meetings designed to bring the latest information on issues facing today's county leaders. We thank you for joining us as we move counties forward together. That's our hashtag for this conference, and we encourage you to tweet about what you are hearing and learning throughout the conference. That's hashtag counties forward together. Now, a little bit about today's webinar. Counties are reopening to the public for a range of services, including driver's license transactions and vehicle registrations, applying for services, paying taxes, and searching for records. A new company, No Wait Inside, is helping counties change the way people are obtaining these services in three New York counties and in counties across the U.S. Their solution combines online scheduling, customer communication, contact tracing, and an efficiency dashboard to allow counties to safely and efficiently offer face-to-face and virtual services to your citizens. We are joined this morning by a distinguished presenter who is bringing this solution to counties across the nation to help them reopen safely to the public. First, though, I want to pause and thank IntelliPure for sponsoring this session. For over 40 years, IntelliPure has been reimagining the world as a better, safer place with innovative air purification technologies. Their solutions are engineered in the USA and trusted everywhere air quality matters. Indoor air quality problems come in all shapes and sizes. They are proud. IntelliPure is proud that their industry-leading patented DFS, which stands for Disinfecting Filtration System, technology is being used in government facilities, hospitals, commercial office buildings, hotels, schools, universities, and many mission critical environments across the globe. Again, thank you, IntelliPure. IntelliPure is a New York company with its home office right here in Oswego County, New York. If you have questions during this presentation, please type them into the question panel in your webinar dashboard, and we will take them up after the speaker finishes his presentation. At this time, it's my pleasure to introduce this afternoon's speaker. David Waxberg is an account manager with No Wait Inside, a cloud-based queue management software tool assisting governments safely service their residents during the COVID-19 pandemic. David has extensive experience with customer service and hospitality management, having spent several years as a senior sales manager and director of sales for Marriott International. David brings a passion to taking care of customers, and now he is bringing that passion to his work with counties as they are looking for the best ways to reopen to the public. David was born in Teaneck, New Jersey, and he has worked with No Wait Inside since the beginning of the pandemic. He currently lives in Chicago with his wife and daughter. David, thank you for joining us this afternoon.
Mark, good afternoon. Thank you so much for that introduction, and good afternoon, New York counties. It is a pleasure to be on this call with you. I'm excited to go through some of the things about how we are going to help reopen counties across the country, and not only across the country, but also in New York. If we can go to the next slide, Kate. When our two co-founders, Mike and Jeff, first thought of this software, back in probably April of this year, they realized that there was going to be a problem during this pandemic. Waiting in a waiting room at a doctor's office or at a dentist, or waiting in line at a DMV or at a county building, that's going to have to change with the pandemic. We know that social distancing, staying 6 feet apart, wearing a mask, washing your hands, doing all of those things that we know that the scientists are telling us, that's really the thing of the future. That's what we're going to be dealing with for quite some time. There is also a lot of anxiety when it comes to waiting in a waiting room or waiting in line. I took my daughter to the dentist just a few weeks ago, and I had some anxiety as well. You know, where am I going to sit? She's 7 years old. Can she go to the dentist all by herself? Should I wait in my car? Do I wait on the sidewalk? Do I wait in the waiting room? Where do I go? Not only did I have anxiety, but my wife, Shirley, had plenty of anxiety. And so how are we going to get our residents, our customers, if you will, how do we get them back to a new normal? How do we bring them back to our county buildings? How do we get them the services that they desperately need and that we as county officials, how do we get those services to them? We want to be able to do that. If we go to the next slide, please. You know, it's not just concerns, you know, just by our customers, but we also have our employees that are concerned too. We know that our employees, our administrative staff, they're concerned about coming back to work. You know, can they service their customers with a mask on? Is there a plexiglass shield that is going to keep someone apart from them? Will the people in the building stay 6 feet apart? Are they anti-maskers, right? Our employees don't know this. And so there's a level of concern from our employees. And if they aren't, if they don't feel safe, they're not going to come to work. And if they do come to work, they're not going to be as productive as they were pre-COVID. The great thing about appointment software is that it reduces the infection risk and limits interaction. We all know that the less time you spend interacting with someone with the disease potentially, the less you have a chance of contracting the virus. And so an appointment software helps to reduce that. Any software that you look at will also probably combine efficiency and safety objectives in the process. And all of this will lead to happier employees and customers, which is really a true win-win for the customer, for you as an county official, and also for your staff. Next slide, please. You know, when Mark and I were talking about this webinar, you know, I did some research, and, you know, I do this research across the country, of course, because I handle multiple states, both in the Northeast and also in the Midwest. But New York State has obviously specific recommendations. And what you see here is specifically from the industry guidance and reopening. And those best practices are to implement a quote, by appointment only policy to limit walk-in customers and congregation. Walk-in customers who are not able to immediately serve should be provided a time to return, and ask customers to wait in their cars or outside the facility at least 6 feet away until the appointment time. So, you know, any software that you're working with should be able to communicate with those citizens, with those customers, that it's their turn to come inside. We can go to the next slide. And again, so any real solution that you're going to be using really should have what we call just-in-time servicing. And so, you know, being able to have that phone and texting ability as a tool to communicate with the residents. And the platform should be able to communicate with them, set up expectations, reduce the anxiety, and efficiently service them. Next slide, please. So what's important when it comes to selecting a partner that you're going to use for an appointment software? First off, the partner should be able to help with scheduling, have complete flexibility with time slot or walk-in appointments. They should be able to have customer communications. It should be able to be customized. You know, one size does not fit all. You know, different counties that are on the call today are going to be different than the customers that we have right now and customers in the future. And so it has to be customized. Big counties, small counties, rural counties, urban, large, small, right? It has to be customized. They should also have a dashboard that you can use, should be used for database and reporting. The reporting that they have should be robust so that you know what departments are using what messages, and all of that, so you can really see what's going on in each of those departments. Next slide, Kate. Thank you. And then the other question you should be asking is, what technology does your vendor use? Amazon Web Services is obviously a really large partner, not only of ours, but I'm sure many of our competitors as well. AWS is secure, it's reliable, it's scalable. They have 6 US data centers in the US and they are expanding. Does your vendor live in a HIPAA compliant environment? Not only do we see our treasurers and our assessors and our auditors that we work with, you know, they use this, but this kind of software, this appointment software, can also be used by Health and Human Services. And so, you know, it needs to make sure that it is secure and it lives in that HIPAA compliant environment. So I'd make sure to ask that question as well. Is the data encrypted? Ourselves, No Wait Inside, we have a staff, we have someone on staff who is a certified information system security professional, a CISSP. And so what kind of questions do you have when it comes to encryption, and is the data protected? We'll go to the next slide. And so how are you going to implement an appointment-based system? The first thing you need to do is define the appointment and walk-in process. What process works for your county, your courthouse, wherever it might be? You know, do you have specific processes in place? Is there security? Does someone have to go through a security line? Are there metal detectors? Where does everyone work in the building? Is the treasurer's office up on the fourth floor? Are they down in the basement? Where is, you know, the auditor's office? Is it downstairs? Is it upstairs? So you have to think about that. Also defining the users, the locations, the pools. So who's going to be utilizing this system? Is it going to be just the elected officials? Will it be the administrative staff? How many different departments or locations within your county are you going to have? Is it going to be everyone, or is it only going to be one or two? Is the vendor that you're working with, is it an all or nothing thing? Can it be customized? Then you want to be able to implement the software. And you also need to be able to communicate the process to your customers and your employees. Are you going to do PR? Are you going to take out radio ads or newspaper ads, TV ads? How are the people in the county going to know that we're moving to an appointment-based system? And the final step is to assess the results, refine the process. Any software that you utilize should be able to pivot quickly, that if something's not working, you can change it. And who can change it? Does it have to be the company, or can it be the users that are using it within the county building? Next slide, please. The customers that we have right now, and we're going up on over almost 70 counties that we're working with, counties and municipalities. And again, we just started this program about 5 months ago. We've stood this program up very quickly, and we already have about 70 customers across the US. But really, our customers are using our software for a variety of applications. A treasurer, an assessor, the DMV. When it comes to healthcare, do you run COVID-19 test sites from a county perspective? How are you going to administer flu shots? That can't be done telehealth, that has to be done in person. Your traffic court, your circuit court, your jury duty, how are all of those going to be handled? You can't call in a jury pool of 200 people and have them sit in the courtroom and wait for them to be asked questions, right? That has to be done maybe a dozen at a time, depending on the size of the building. Voter registration, how are you going to do in-person voting, early voting? That process should be starting really in the next few weeks. And law enforcement, fingerprinting, gun permitting, jail visitation by not only attorneys, but also by family members and friends. So really any face-to-face interaction or any service that requires a face-to-face interaction, really any software that you're gonna use should be able to accomplish that. Next slide. Now, an appointment-based software system is really only as good as the scheduling options that they have for you. One way to do it is by a first-in, first-out. Ourselves at No Wait Inside, we call this FIFO or a queue system. This is what you would normally see at the DMV. You would see this at a deli or at a bakery. That machine that we've all seen before, that red machine with the numbers in it, you pull a number and you are serviced in the order in which you pull that number, right? That's one of the ways to do it. The other way to do scheduling is by block scheduling. So this is what you would see at the doctor or at the dentist. We're all really used to this. You know, you make an appointment at a certain time and you are seen at that time, or hopefully right around that time. You know, there could be multiple appointments at a given time, right? You could see multiple, there could be multiple doctors in the practice and there's multiple 8:15 appointments. And so you're gonna determine how you want your schedules to be done. Again, any vendor that you work with should have a varying ways of offering schedules. Next slide, please. Now, you know, budgets are stretched thin right now. We know that, right? Tax revenue is down, people aren't working, and, you know, how are you going to pay for something like this? A few things. First off, we're hearing from a lot of our counties that CARES Act funds from the government can be used for this, and they are being used for this. But if you think about how is your staff going to accomplish this? Well, if your staff is going to be taking phone calls and making appointments, it could take them 5 to 7 minutes to make an appointment. And if they're getting paid $30 an hour, that's 50 cents a minute. So if they're going to be on the phone with a citizen for 5 to 7 minutes to make an appointment for, you know, the assessor's office, that cost increase is now $2.50 or $3.50 per appointment. With a schedule and communications platform, you're taking the idea of citizens calling in directly. They're going to be able to make their appointments on their own through a website likely, and utilizing maybe 3 or 4 text messages or phone calls. Text messages and phone calls are probably about 5 cents a piece. And so you're talking about 15 to 20 cents per appointment as opposed to $2.50 to $3.50 an appointment. So what you're really doing is you're really reducing the cost that's on you, on the county, when it comes to using one of these software companies. If we can go to the next slide. I'd like to spend a few minutes talking about my company, No Wait Inside. We can go to the next slide as well. We have been in business, I should say, the company's been in business for over 20 years. This software itself builds on a lot of the software technology that we have been using over the last many years. Our co-founders, Mike and Jeff, have been in the government software technology space for about 20 years, mostly in law enforcement as well. So a lot of the technology that they have already was easily able to be put in place for No Wait Inside in this software. We currently have 3 New York customers: Washington County, Fulton County, and Westchester County. So this really ranges from, you know, smaller counties like Fulton County, mid-sized county like Washington County, and all the way up, obviously, to a very, very large county like Westchester County. I did put some of the contacts we've been working with here. Stephanie Lemery is the county clerk in Washington County. Terry McNall is the director of IT in Washington County. Perry Lovell is the director of IT in Fulton County. He's also a board member of NYSLGITDA. Mark was able to pronounce the acronym for me. I forgot what it was or how to pronounce it, but he has been a true supporter of ours as well. We can go to the next slide. Washington County has done a really great job of implementing our software on their website. So here, this is the front page of their website. And here you'll see that they have a, in red, I circled that in red, schedule in-office appointments at different departments. So if you click on that, the next slide will come up. And you can see here that they have in here a couple of other ways to get to these departments: the Department of Motor Vehicles, the County Clerk, and the Archives. These are the 3 departments in Washington County that are utilizing our system. And if you go to the next slide, you'll see that the next thing they'll get is a little window. This window pops up and asks for a few things. What location or department are you looking to get service from? Again, it's DMV, County Clerk, or Archives. And then what service is being requested from those departments? Here we have a DMV example. A customer from Washington County or a citizen from Washington County will put in their first name, last name, and mobile phone number. They'll pick the day of the appointment that they want and their time slot. As you can see here, I took this screenshot over the weekend. And you'll see here that Washington County's DMV is already booked out till October 19th. The nice thing here is that a customer isn't going to need to come in and just wait in line like maybe we used to. They know that their next appointment is October 19th, and you sign up and you come in the day that you want. You don't have to waste time out of work coming down. Are you going to get service today? Do you have to spend 2 or 3 hours here? No, you're going to come in for the time that works for you. And I'll show you a little bit more of the demo in just a few minutes about our website. But if we can go to the next slide, I'll show you exactly how it works. So in our system, what we do is we have we help the counties with these appointment-based systems. So a citizen would make an appointment. They would receive a phone call and a text message before the appointment. Within that text message, there's going to be a hyperlink that they'll click on when they arrive at the county building or at the courthouse or at the jail or wherever it might be. And then they're going to click on that link when they've arrived. What that does is it sends a message to the folks inside who are manning the dashboard. And when it is safe for that customer to come inside, the staff inside sends a text message and or a phone call to that customer saying, it's safe for you to come inside. The last person has left the window, or you know, it is safe to come inside. We've wiped down the area. The message is sent and the customer comes inside. And then that process repeats throughout the day as there are more and more appointments. We go to the next slide, please. On the left-hand side here, you're going to see that blue hyperlink that I mentioned. That's what someone would click on. On the right-hand side is an example of a mobile device web page that we use to show people where they are in the queue. So for instance, if you were coming in and you were number 3, when you refresh this page, you'll see it goes from 3 to 2 to 1, and then you know that you're going to be next to call inside. Next slide. And finally, you know, what are the outcomes? What's the return on investment for when you implement an appointment-based system? You're going to be able to orderly return back to a new normal, right? This effectively manages your customer backlog. We know that, you know, there are some offices that are open, some are not, but there are people who have not gotten service for the last 5 or 6 months, and they're going to need to come back in. How are they going to do that? What any appointment-based software is going to do, it's going to reduce the anxiety. It's going to lower the infection risk, and it's going to increase customer satisfaction. I think the last three that are on there, reduce anxiety, lower infection risk, and increase customer satisfaction, is really everything that a county official, everyone who's working in government, really wants to see, right? We all need to be reducing the infection risk. We need to be wearing those masks and social distancing. And increasing customer satisfaction will only help you with your constituents within the county. I do want to spend a couple of minutes just showing a few of our features. Kate, if you wouldn't mind allowing me to share my screen. Here we go. All right, I think you should be able to see my screen. Oops. All right. Let me just see what you guys can see. Yep, you can see my screen. Oops. All right. So this is our dashboard. This is what you would see when you log in to No Wait Inside. What I want to do first is I want to make an appointment. I want to show you what our system can do. The first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to make an appointment. This is an example of an appointment that someone would make if they were to come to your county's webpage. So in our webpage, we're going to use the Plymouth DMV example. That's usually what we use in our demos. We're going to have that person do a road test today. All right. I'm going to put in my first name, my last name, my phone number. And I'm going to say that I'm going to make an appointment today. In our system, you can make an appointment 5 days in advance. But again, this is fully customizable. I'm going to make a time slot. Again, I'm in Chicago, so it's almost 1:30 here. I know it's 2:30 where you folks are. And something else I really want to show you here, something that I think sets No Wait Inside apart from our competitors, are our screening questions. These screening questions are really powerful. These allow you to ask specific questions before an appointment, after an appointment, or before an appointment comes in. And what you can do is you can ask these questions. They could be COVID screening questions. They could be questions about the office that you're looking for. But let's just see what happens when I answer these questions. Have you had COVID-19 in the last 14 days? If I were to say yes, a window pops up and it shows you I can't make an appointment. All right. I'm going to answer these obviously the correct way so I can show you this. I have all the documents. This is here, another place where I can text something. No special needs. I can text that. And do you live in the town of Plymouth? Yes. I'm going to click on this link. And once I do that, I'm going to receive a phone call and a text message on my phone. I'm going to go ahead and answer that phone for you, so you'll hear it in just a second.
This is a reminder for your 1:30 p.m. appointment. After this call, you will receive a text message with a link to click when you arrive at our facility. Once you arrive, please click the link and stay in your car or wait outside until we are ready for you. Once we are ready, we will provide you further instructions. Thanks.
So that was the phone call I just got. And I'm going to receive a text message in just a second with a lot of that same information. That text message says, when you arrive for your 1:30 appointment, click on this link. And remember, you saw that link before. So we know you're here. Please stay in your car outside until we text you when we're ready. So here's the dashboard that your folks inside of your county buildings or your courthouses will see. This is our dashboard. Again, this is for our driver's road test. A few things to note here. You can see the person's screening questions and what they answered here by clicking on screening questions. You also have the ability to go through a few of the different options here. You can edit someone's appointment, cancel, close. You can send them a custom message if you wanted to. You also have the ability of closing a pool here. So for instance, if we close this, that means that nobody else is able to make an appointment during that day. So if your staff gets overwhelmed, if you have people that are going home early, they're just not able to be there, you know, you can close your pool and not have any more appointments. You also have the ability to send a custom message to everybody who's waiting. Let's say you wanted to send a message and say, we are running late. Please be patient. You can send that by text message, by phone, or both. Click on this, and it'll copy that message. But what I want to do is I want to go ahead and show you when I click on this message on my phone, take a look at what happens on my screen. As you can see, there's a little bell that goes off. And my tile here is turned orange. So now the staff inside knows that I am waiting outside. What I can do is I can send an acknowledgement text message just by clicking on that button. I'll read that to you right now. And the text message I just got says, David, we know you are here. We will let you know as soon as we are ready for you. Thank you. Great. Well, guess what? It's now time for my road test. If I'm working inside, I'm going to call myself inside. It's kind of a weird situation because I'm calling myself. But I'm going to call myself inside. I'm going to let you listen to the message one more time.
David, we are ready for you inside. Please come inside the building, go down the stairs, and we are the third window on the left. Thanks.
So as I mentioned before, the idea of any appointment software really needs to be customization. The message that you heard, the message I read, the phone call you heard, all of that is customizable within our website. So any of the different departments that use our software is going to have different messaging, whether because it's the location that they have or the instructions that they need to give their citizens, all of that's fully customizable. You have the ability here to check additional days further out or any day that you want. You can search by phone number or name. You also have access to our appointments page, or this is really your appointments. And you can see here, these are all the appointments. You can search for them by name. Let's say I wanted to look up all of my appointments. I have a lot of them, obviously, because I do a lot of demos. You can also go ahead and you can export these to PDF or Excel. Now, there is a number of other items on here on the left-hand side that I'd love to go through with you. I don't want to spend too much time on that. I do want to get to a question and answer session if you have any questions. But again, I would be happy to show more in-depth demo of all of our software and all of our features at another time if you would like. Mark, I'm going to go ahead and kick it back to you.
Thanks very much, David. I remind our webinar attendees that if you have a question, please type the question into your question panel on your webinar dashboard. First question, David. So have counties seen a reduction in the number of customers that they can see in a day as a result of the queue system that No Wait Inside is using in a number of counties?
Sure, thanks, Mark. We're actually seeing an increase in the number of customers that that a county can see. You know, they are able to schedule the appointments. You can very likely get more appointments in because you can really tailor the appointments based on the service type that you have. So if it's a DMV, you can have the folks who need to only get this service go over here, folks that need this service go over here. What we also understand from a lot of our DMV partners across the country is they're saying that even if COVID were to end today or tomorrow, they would continue to use this site or this this software because the feedback that they're getting from their customers is really positive. You know, we're used to making appointments for things, whether it be the dentist or the doctor, we're used to this, right? And so to move, to pivot to this in a DMV example, it's not out of the realm of possibility. And people are expecting change with COVID, how they interact with their doctors or their dentists or their DMV or their county government. So the customers are having a very positive feedback here.
So for counties that do decide to go with No Wait Inside or a similar a solution, how do they promote it? How do they let citizens know that this, I know it's probably different in every county, but do you have some examples of how some counties have let their residents know if they want to go to the DMV, this is the way they need to schedule a meeting?
Absolutely. So, you know, there obviously needs to be some PR, some public relations here about how you're going to move to an appointment-based software system. Some counties, as I mentioned earlier, some are taking out print ads. Some are doing media buys, either in traditional media like newspapers. Some are putting it up on Facebook, on their Instagram web pages, on Twitter. You know, there are lots of different ways to do this. I think the most effective way to do this is by putting information on your website. You know, one of the counties that I work with in Iowa put a really big red box right in the middle of their homepage that said, "If you need to come in for service, make an appointment." You know, so there's really a call out there. There's a call to action. I think that's the way you're going to get your citizens to actually to take to this new change, is that there has to be a call to action. We also have seen some people do, and some counties do, they'll put sandwich boards outside of their buildings. It could have a QR code on there, so they know that they need to make an appointment for service. They can take a picture with the QR code and it'll bring right up any sort of appointment website and they can make an appointment there. Some counties have kiosks in their buildings. If they have a really large lobby, they might put one kiosk over here, one kiosk over here, and people can come into the building and make an appointment when they get there because maybe they didn't know up front. You know, it takes a little bit of time to educate our citizens, you know, but there are ways to do that. And a lot of them are actually really inexpensive.
The association acronym that you referred to is NYSGLITA, which is the Local Government IT Directors Association.
Yeah, so, thank you, Mark.
And the reason I say that is, who does, from the county perspective, who works with No Wait Inside?
Sure, that's a really great question. We're finding a lot of our organic search comes from IT. Very likely, a county clerk has asked their IT partner, listen, we need to move to an appointment-based system. You know, if we're gonna reopen, we need to do this. And the IT folks are organically searching online and they're reaching out to us directly. Sometimes I'm reaching out as well to folks in the IT space. But we're seeing the initial call come from IT, and then the initial demo that we're doing is usually with IT and the county clerk, maybe the treasurer, right? Some folks who might be interested. And then, you know, sometimes we do even a second demo with the same people and then even more people. So, you know, it usually starts with the IT staff, mostly because they were told that they needed to find a solution.
Okay, great. So if somebody on the call right now, and by the way, this session is being recorded. Our slides will be available this afternoon. So you can, somebody from a county, you can send this to somebody in your county if you want to pursue this further. David, what should a county official do if they think they want to explore No Wait Inside further?
Sure. First, I would say thank you. Thank you for your interest. But you know, reach out to me directly. My information is on the slides as well. Reach out to me either by phone or by email. I would be happy to walk through another demo with you and anyone else on your staff that is interested. You know, there's no right number of demos that need to be done. I've done 3, 4, and 5 demos because, you know, it could have been a couple months ago, and now we need a refresher, whatever it might be. You know, when it comes to a support and implementation process for our software, not only am I here to help with the sales efforts and the demo, but I'm also here to help implement and support any of our counties that I work with to get the system up and running. So you're going to see my face a lot. You're going to hear my voice a lot because I do all the support too. You know, we're a small company. You know, we stood this thing up since April. And so, you know, there's probably a dozen of us. We're a close family, but you know, we're all happy to support you in getting your buildings up and running and servicing your customers safely.
Great. Thank you, David. No more questions here. I want to thank you. I also want to let our webinar attendees know that No Wait Inside's information, they came to us because they work with counties in New York, they work with counties in Iowa, and they're working with the counties in Pennsylvania. So our county association colleagues from other states have also let us know and given a strong reference for No Wait Inside. So thank you, David. Thank you for spending your time with us this afternoon. I'd also again like to recognize today's workshop sponsor, IntelliPure. Thank you, IntelliPure, for making this possible. You can find a recording of this webinar and a copy of the slide deck on our website at www.nisac.org/fallseminar. We invite you to join us tomorrow for 2 more virtual fall seminar workshops. Tomorrow at 10 a.m., counties, mental health, and the criminal justice process. And then at 2 p.m., we have Meeting New York State's climate and renewable energy goals. Please stay with us for the virtual fall seminar. It's going on now through October 1st. From your team here at NYSAC, we wish you all the best. Take care and be healthy.